Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kapke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each episode of this podcast, we're going to cover another 3D modeling tool, and today's 3D modeling tool is Normal Rotate. This is actually episode 1 and I am doing a remake of episode 1 because I've improved so much after making so many episodes for this podcast that I really wanted to go back and do a remake of this episode, and I may do further updates to other episodes as well so that I can provide you with the best possible content to learn 3D modeling inside of Cinema 4D. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how Normal Rotate works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. The first thing that I'm going to do is drop in a cube here. And here you can see that we have different types of primitives. That's what these are called. This whole drop-down menu is made up of primitives. And primitives have settings unique to them. Like what you can see here, you can choose the number of segments this cube has. And I'll change this to garage shading line so that you can see it a little bit better. But here I can increase the number of segments and you'll see what effect that is taking on our cube. You can choose to add fillets and there's other settings here. I'm going to, for right now, increase the segments to 4. That looks good to me. And if I want to take this primitive and make it editable so that we can affect the mesh on it, you'll see that there's this button here and it says make editable, and it'll also show you what the hotkey is for this. So you can also hit the C button in order to get this to be editable. And you'll see that instead of having a cube icon here like before, now we have this polygon icon here telling us that this object is editable. And with that done, we can switch from object or model mode into polygon mode. And we can select these polygons here with our cube selected and begin editing them. So we're going over the hotkey normal rotate. You can find most of your modeling tools with the M button here, and you'll see that they're all listed. And the very first tool on our list says normal rotate, and next to that you can see is a comma. So what that means is that the hotkey for the tool we're learning today is M comma. So that's how we can activate it. So I'll do that right now, M comma. And now with that done, you can see we have normal rotate showing up within our attribute manager. And there's a few different ways you can use this tool. The first way is you can just choose an amount to rotate this in here. Like let's say we're going to rotate this 30 degrees. And then one way for us to apply this amount is to hit apply. And now you can see it's rotated our polygons 30 degrees. I can also click on these polygons here. If I wanted to apply that exact same transformation to another area, I can do that by hitting new transform and it'll apply it there. You can also click and drag your mouse and you'll see that that will actually update the rotation. You want to make sure that you don't rotate it so far that you see these black polygons. That means that you're starting to have intersections with your geometry, and that's not good to have that within your mesh while you're 3D modeling. So make sure that nothing is showing this type of error. Here it looks good, here it doesn't. So just something to keep in mind while you're doing this. And this tool is pretty helpful because it can rotate polygons in the normal direction, and that can be useful for 3D modeling. And then you can make extrusions. I held down control while holding down the Y arrow, and you can be getting some interesting shapes doing that. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful today on normal rotate. If you have any questions for me, please leave them in the comments below. And thank you so much for watching. If you'd like to learn new 3D modeling tools, please hit like and subscribe so that you're notified the next time I come out with a tutorial. I plan on covering all of the 3D modeling tools within Cinema 4D, and we're also going to 3D model some fun things here. So if you're interested in that, please stay tuned, and I'll see you next time on Ambient 3D Animations. Thank you so much for watching.